Hey, what's good everybody, how y'all doing today? In this video, I'm going to show you how you could use an external SSD onto your Steam Deck as a storage option. There's only a few catches with this thing. For one, the Steam Deck only comes with one USB port, which is very unfortunate, so you cannot connect this bad boy on the Steam Deck and charge at the same time. Two, you can only auto mount on in desktop mode, not in game mode. So hopefully in the near future, Steam will send out a software update where it could auto mount in both desktop and game mode. But for right now, it's only in desktop mode. Like I said, this process is so simple, even a caveman can do it. So anyhow, you just order this brand new SSD external, but you got to format it. So I'm going to show you what to do to format this bad boy and use it on Steam Deck and the option you could use so you could auto mount in desktop mode. All right, here we go. Right here, I got an old Fujitsu laptop, which is running Windows 10. If you're the type that got a new laptop or desktop, it doesn't matter, you're still good to go. This one doesn't have a USB type C port. You only got a USB type B. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to connect my USB type C to USB type B cable onto my external. So first I'm going to connect it with a USB C port. Then I'm going to connect this part onto my PC. All right. Next up, what I'm going to do right here, I'm gonna type in disk manager. So disk manager come up. So I'm gonna click it. So you can see in disk manager, let me zoom in real quick to show you guys. In disk manager, it shows up right there as unallotted. So, and that's gonna be in disk, that's gonna be my right here disk one, and it's unallotted. So what you're gonna do, you're gonna right click it, you're gonna go into new simple volume. New simple volume, you're gonna click next. Once you click next, you're just gonna click next again, and it's gonna assign a letter. You could assign it to any letter you want, E, D, B, whatever. So it's right there in E, so I'm just gonna assign it to letter E. Next, make sure that it's on this right here, NTFS. Default, all of this, you want that. Leave it at that, NTFS, because that's what the Steam Deck recognizes for any hard drive, I should say. Then you're gonna click next. Then you can come up as this, complete the new simple volume wizard, click finish. And it's formatting. So right there, boom, it's finished. So you got a healthy basic data partition. So right there, it's formatted, you're good to go. What you're gonna do next, you're gonna easily close out of it. And then you're gonna remove your SSD from your PC. This is the next part. If you still don't have a USB type C to USB type C cable, but you got to remember, your Steam Deck only got a USB type C port. If you have any one of these right here, could from your old cell phone, a USB type B to USB type C connector, you could use it on the Steam Deck and connect your USB type B cable and connect your external, which will work just fine. But if you have a USB type C to USB type C cable, that would be perfect. Especially if you're gonna get a USB type C cable, you want something like this right here. This one is a USB type C 3.1. These USB type C cables are thicker and it's made for high speed data transfer. So the best option, just look for a nice thick USB type C cable that have the writing on it, USB 3.1. So I'm gonna connect this bad boy here like this onto my Steam Deck. The light on, that means it's on. You got to remember, in game mode, it won't recognize it, it won't be there. And to show you what I mean, let me bring it up closer. I'm gonna show you. I've got to get the cord out of the way. I'm gonna go right here into settings to show you it won't recognize in game mode. And that's where we're gonna get to the meat of the matter. So right here in storage, you can see it's not there. It only will work in game desktop mode. And then when we set it up in desktop mode, then we can see it in game mode. So let's just do this real quick. First, you got to go into desktop mode like this. Put it down. Now we're in desktop mode. As you can see right here, it's saying mount and open. So we're just going to click it right here. Mount and open. And this folder is empty, as you can see. There's nothing inside this folder, it's brand new. So let's go back out here. And we're gonna go right here into the Steam. Click the Steam right here. Then you're gonna go into settings. Once you're in settings, you want to go to downloads. Once you download, you're gonna click Steam, library and folders. And right here, you see the plus? You're going to hit the plus right here. And it's going to pop up as this. Add a new Steam library folder. You're going to want to click add. Once you click add, it's right here now in your Steam folder. But you got to remember what I said earlier. This would only work in desktop mode, only for auto mount. But anyway, let me just get to the meat of the matter. So, you got it right here. What you're gonna do, you're gonna close it next. And then, let me close this again. And what I'm gonna do right here, I'm gonna go back into right here, which is most recent device. You wanna go into settings. And in settings, it's usually in settings, when you go into settings, it's gonna show up as this. Nothing is assigned. But what you want to do, you want to click this, enable automatic mount or remove media. And what you want to do, I select these right here. I select these and I realize when I select these right here, it auto mounts immediately when I put it in desktop mode. So you want to do this. So when you start back a Steam Deck and you go into desktop mode, it will automatically auto mount. So let me just get out of here real quick and show you in game mode. Sometimes this mouse can be very tricky. Okay, let me go back in game mode and show you your external in game mode. So let me go back in here. First gotta hit Steam, go all the way to settings, and you can do this. Right in storage, you see right there. New volume. And you could assign it as your main by pressing you can make it as the default. Press X, you can make it as your default. And you can move your games over, which is a cool thing. So you can also move your games over onto your new external SSD. Now, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna show you that when I turn it off, you're not gonna see it in game mode. And when I put it in desktop mode, you're gonna see it's gonna auto mount. Now I've got my Steam Deck back on. I'm gonna show you that when I turn it back on, it's not gonna be there in game mode. See, it's not there in game mode. But the good thing is, with the options I select, once you go into desktop mode, it should auto mount. So I'm gonna go into a desktop mode right now. I'm gonna show you that it auto mount. Or once it auto mount, it can come back into game mode and everything will be good to go. I'm gonna wait on this bad boy here to clear up a little bit. Okay, good. So let's go back here to most recent device. You can see right there, it's already auto mounted. So you ain't gotta worry about nothing. What you could do if you want to double check something, that is already good to go. You could go back into Steam, into settings, just to check downloads. Go into your Steam library, and it's still there because it's auto mounted. So that means everything is working accordingly. And now, before I go back into game mode, I'm just gonna make it show you something real quick. Once you're in this area, it's easy to move your games over in desktop mode than game mode. Because in desktop mode, you can always select your games by clicking here. But in game mode, you'd have to do it individually. But in desktop mode, you can select several games and move it over onto your new drive. Just to let you guys know. So let's go back here. Let's go back into game mode. Let's close this. And let's go back into game mode to show you that it's there waiting for you. So back into game mode. Let's go back into settings. Storage, and it's still right there waiting for you, just like that. See, it's very simple. Like I said, even a caveman can do it. This is JC. Thanks for tuning in. So now you know, if you got a external storage, you can use it on your Steam Deck. Just follow the simple steps and you'll be good to go. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. I'll really appreciate it. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for tuning in.